I think we relish the winning ugly label, because as long as you have winning in front of something, that's a compliment.
I think it was originally coined by Raider in Texas that it was, kind of derogatory. Oh, these guys, they're not blowing anybody out. But you know what? That's the game of baseball. If you play it the right way and you advance runners and you make your outs be productive, you've got a chance to win. And so I think that was kind of a rallying cry for us, because we knew that we could score runs without any hits.
We went out and played and laid it on the line every day, and we weren't concerned about whether we won it pretty or how we did it. We just took a lot of pride in trying to go out and figure out how to get it done.
Some games we did win ugly, but I think it was mostly, when we played the Texas Rangers, we just found a way to win the ball game. I mean, that's what it came down to. We never gave up, and some of the games were real ugly, but when you never give up, you always have a chance to win.
We had won a lot of games that year that they weren't artistically beautiful. They weren't always a well-pitched game. They were close games. Sometimes the other team would throw the ball away and we'd win. And that's what Raider was talking about. He said we were winning ugly. But once we got going, we weren't winning ugly. We were blowing everybody away.
You need a little phrase to drive you, or a little logo, or a little something, because that makes everything you do magnified even more. So we thank Doug Raider for that little mention that day. And we rode it right till the end.
All we need is one hit and one run, Lauren.
You got that right. And the Mariners are going to pull their infield in. The outfield is playing shallow. Here's the pitch to Baines. Swing and a fly ball. This will be it. Center fielder's got it. Cruz is tagged. Here's the throw. Not in time. Stop swim. The White Sox have won the 1983 American League Western Division.
The night we clinched at Old Comiskey Park, I just remember the flood of emotion.
That was a feeling I'd never expected.
I think it was the fastest I've ever sprinted out of the bullpen.
Still see Juice jumping up in the air, hitting home plate, Bainesy turning at first base, knowing, hey, no matter what we do now, we're in the playoffs no matter what.
It's like when he hit home plate, the whole place erupted. I mean, and it erupted for me, from my feet all the way to the top of my head. It was just excitement out there.
When I hit home plate, I was happy. And then when I went into the dugout and everybody was celebrating, I stepped out to the side and reflected, gosh, I scored against my old team, and those guys are going home in last place. The season's over for them. And I felt for them because I was with them for 6 years. But then I also was happy in the fact that I was going to playoffs to experience something that I've never experienced before.
See everybody out on the field, and then just hugging and jumping on piles and stuff. It was just a phenomenal experience. I'd never experienced that before.
I guess it's one of those things like the birth of a child. You can't really explain it until you've experienced it.
I think a lot of people experienced joy. But there was a sense of relief in that we've proven what it takes to win ball games.
Julio Cruz scored the winning run with Jimmy Leland right behind me.
All right, here we go. Where are we? All right.
spring training, I knew we had a catalyst of a great team, and everybody was just goofy enough to win it all, and here we are. It's nice. It's really nice. It's nice to win the game the way we did. We came back again, and you can't say enough about the guys on this team.
This is the greatest team effort I've ever seen. Greatest bunch of guys, working totally, everybody pulling together, nobody having a great year, but everybody doing the job when they had to. Greatest feeling in the world.
Our pitching staff kept us in the game all night tonight, and then our offense finally took over and scored them a run when we needed it. But our pitching staff's been there for 2.5 months, so we are where we are because our pitching staff is what they are.
Well, I don't know. I think everybody's enjoying themselves, but I've been in this organization for 10 years, and this is the best I've ever felt. It's an easy club to manage, to be honest. All they would do is want to come out and play. For anybody that says it's not an emotion or excited ball club, just listen to this clubhouse.
I waited for the players to have their celebration in the clubhouse and went in later, and Tony La Russa said it finally quieted down, and then when I came in, it erupted again, and it was one of the great moments of my career, and they lifted me up and just about drowned me with liquids, champagne, and beer. So it's a moment that you never forget because it doesn't happen very often in the lifetime, and especially with the type of club we had.
Me and Harold, we didn't drink, so we had Sprite, and we were shaking that up and spraying each other with that. And we had a great time, and we participated in the celebration. But then after all that went down, we all sat around and we talked about the season and praised everyone in that room. And that's something that I really remember and I treasure.
Back then, I was so young, I didn't take it all in the way I should. But, when you see all the old videos and guys start reminiscing about it, it was a great feeling.
It's one of the greatest days we've ever lived.